everyone. Today I am explaining the continuation of the unit 2, vector spaces 2. The first of all, this is the theorem, very important theorem. The statement of this theorem is, if W1 and W2 be two subspaces of a vector space V of F, then prove that dimension of W1 plus W2 is equal to dimension of W1 plus dimension of W2 minus dimension of W1 intersection W2. Here W1 and W2 are two finite subspaces, and find the value of W1 intersection W2. But here dimension of W1 plus W2 value is equal to dimension of W1 plus dimension of W2 minus dimension of W1 intersection W2. This is the most important theorem from second unit. Another theorem is, W be a subspace of finite dimensional vector space, then dimension of V by W is equal to dimension of V minus dimension of W. Here also V and W are two finite dimensional vector spaces. The value of dimension of V by W is equal to dimension of V minus dimension of W. Direct sum of two subspaces. Let V of F be a vector space, and W1 and W2 be two subspaces of V of F. Then V is said to be a direct sum of its two subspaces W1 and W2. Each vector of V can be expressed as a linear combination of elements of W1 and W2 in a unique way. In this case, we write V is equal to W1 plus W2. Suppose you have take one example. Let V3 of R be a vector space, and W1 is equal to AB0 such that AB belongs to R. And now you have to take another subspace. W2 is equal to set of 0, 0, C, such that C belongs to R. Here these two are two subspaces of V3 of R. For alpha belongs to V3 of R, and alpha is equal to A, B, C. And here, write alpha is equal to A, B, C is equal to A, B, 0 plus 0, 0, C. This expression is unique. In this case, V is a direct sum of its two subspaces of W1 and W2. Therefore, V is equal to W1 plus W2. Next, now you have to take another example for direct sum of two subspaces. Let V3 of R be a vector space, and W1 and W2 be two subspaces of V3 of R, where W1 is equal to set of, now you have to take the elements A, B, 0 such that AB belongs to R, and another subspace W2 is equal to 0, 0, C such that A comma C belongs to R, and alpha is equal to ABC, that value is equal to A by 2 B 0 plus A by 2 0 C. And alpha can also be expressed as A by 3 B 0 plus 2A by 3 0 C. But this expression is not unique. In this case, V is not a direct sum of its two subspaces of W1 and W2. Therefore, V does not equal to W1 plus W2. Therefore, V is a linear sum of two subspaces. Next theorem. The statement of this theorem is, the necessary and sufficient condition for a vector space V of F to be a direct sum of its two subspaces W1 and W2 are that, first condition is V is equal to W1 plus W2, and the intersection of two subspaces W1 intersection W2 is equal to set of 0. These are the important theorems from the second unit. Now I am explaining the previous video once. Basis of a vector space. What is a basis of a vector space means? V is a vector space and S is subset of V. Then a basis linearly independent spanning set for a vector space. And here let V be a vector space and S is equal to V1, V2, so on up to Vk. That means here S is a finite set. So the two conditions are satisfied by the given elements. First condition is S spans V, that is L of S is equal to V. And the second condition is S is linearly independent. These two conditions are satisfied by the given elements, that is called a basis of a vector space. Next, linear independence property. For every finite subset, here the elements are b1, b2, so on up to bn, and the scalar elements a1, a2, so on up to an in F, and the condition is a1 b1 plus a2 b2 plus so on up to an bn is equal to 0, where the elements a1 is equal to 0, a2 is equal to 0, and after that the last element an is equal to 0. This is the linear independence property. Next, the spanning property. Here, for every vector V in V, is possible to choose V1, V2, V3, so on up to Vn in F, and B1, B2, so on up to Bn in B, such that V is equal to V1, B1 plus V2, B2 plus so on up to Vn, Bn. This is called the spanning property. Next theorem, this is already explained theorem. E1 is equal to 100, E2 is equal to 010, and E3 is equal to 001. Then E1, E2, E3 form a basis of R³. Now you have to take the elements V is equal to X1, X2, X3. And after that the linear combination is expressed as V is equal to X1, E1 plus X2, E2 plus X3, E3. And prove that C1, E1 plus C2, E2 plus C3, E3 is equal to 0. Therefore C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. Individually, the elements are equal to 0. That means C1 is equal to 0, C2 is equal to 0, C3 is equal to 0. Hence, E1, E2, E3 forms a basis of R³. This is the proof of the above theorem. Next, what is a finite dimensional vector space? A vector space V of F is said to be finite dimensional if it has a finite basis. This is the finite dimensional vector space. And what is a null space? The null space of any matrix A consists of all the vectors B such that AB is equal to 0 and B is not 0. This is called the null space. See the definition once. What is a dimension? If a vector space V has a basis consisting of n vectors, then we say that dimension of V is n. Now you have to take V is equal to set of 0 is the 0 vector space. But here the dimension of V is defined as 0. This is called the dimension. Next, dimension of a subspace. Now you have to take W is a subspace of V, the elements W1, W2, so on up to Wm is a linearly independent set. Now after that, the set W1, W2, so on up to Wm, and U1, U2, so on up to Uk, it gives a basis for V, then M plus K is equal to dimension of V. The important theorems are existence theorem. The statement of existence theorem is, for each finite dimensional vector space V, there exists a basis set. This is called existence theorem. Invariance theorem. In invariance theorem, there are two statements. First one is, the number of elements in any two bases of a finite dimensional vector space is invariant, or any two bases of a finite dimensional vector space have the same number of elements. This is called the invariance theorem. Next theorem is extension theorem. Every linear independent subset of a dimensional vector space V of F is either a basis or can be extended to form a basis. This is the extension theorem. Thank you.